Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to our channel and thanks for logging on. Today we're discussing the Audemars Piguet Royal Oak Offshore, nicknamed Safari. This is the reference 26470ST. You can see and you can purchase this 42mm Royal Oak Offshore chronograph on our website. Subscribe to our YouTube channel if you enjoy these videos, and please click on the card in the upper right hand corner of the screen at any time during this video to see our full sales listing for this watch, with additional accessories included in the sale, high resolution images for your desktop, and naturally complete pricing details for this Audemars Piguet Royal Oak Offshore Safari. Now, the Safari debuted in 2007 as the first of a new line of heavily themed Audemars Piguet Royal Oak Offshores, loosely united under the title and banner themes. We saw the Navy, we saw the Volcano, we saw the Panda, we saw the Bumblebee, and of course we saw the Safari, essentially the first of the line, as well as the model that debuted and popularized the now ubiquitous hornback alligator leather strap on the offshores. It was also one of the first Royal Oak Offshores to receive the in-house caliper, the in-house base caliper that powers the watch. So you can see on my wrist, 16 centimeters in circumference. The timepiece is big, bold, and easily surpasses its 42 millimeters in terms of its ergonomics. It feels like a 44 on the wrist. So yes, it may be 42 across the round of the case from 9 to 3, not including crown guards, crown, or pushers, but for all practical intents and purposes, the measurements you're going to want to know are the spans across the wrist. 54 millimeters lug-to-lug if you include, well, the actual lugs, but if you include these intermediate double plots that join the lug to the strap and you have them on both sides, measure them from side to side and they don't bend down, they are stiff. They are 58, are you ready for this? 58.4 millimeters across the wrist. So this is essentially the shape of the watch. I'll give you a better sense of it. Now it's only 14.4 millimeters thick, which may not be as thick as you'd expect for a modular complication in a sports style watch, but this is why the watch effectively wears over 55 millimeters lug to lug. At 58 and rigid, there is some virtual flare to the strap, and that in addition to the fact that the hornback is a notoriously substantial and stiff strap. That said, it works to your advantage if you have that particular wrist size, because the strap is of outstanding quality. The toughness of the leather means it lasts a long time, and you can see that it's joined to the case using screws, not spring bars. That's upscale, that's premium, and that's the kind of security that should be included and designed into every luxury watch. You'll note there is a light contrasting ecru stitch, safari themed, like the blades of grass on a savanna or a plain, and of course you can see the same color on the dial. The watch features an AP full polished single fold deployant logo style buckle, the idea being to loop with the other side of the strap and impart confidence while donning or removing that you won't drop the watch. The strap on its underside is a high grade and supple calfskin, and you can see that the timepiece is beautifully finished. Although brutal in its style, and intentionally so, the Royal Oak Offshore is finished the same standard and with the same loving care and skill as any standard Audemars Piguet timepiece, including and especially the Royal Oaks. The character line running down from the bezel is perfectly aligned through the mid case and case back. You'll note the tapered bevel, the polished element of the flank of the case, becomes a hairline bevel at the mid case and then flares out again on the opposite side. The satin finish perfectly aligned on the lug hoods and the case profile. You can see the bezel gasket, a slim sliver of suggested rubber coloration on the original Royal Oak, is fully expressed as a structural component on the offshore. You'll also note the rounded polished flanks of the bezel contrast with the sharp crease of its lip, as well as the satin finish of its top. You'll note all of the hexagonal bezel bolts feature plenty of sink here. They are not flush with the bezel. You always want to look when purchasing these watches, Royal Oaks or Offshores, to make sure that the bolts are still below the plane of the bezel. That's your signal regarding how often, how much the watch has been refinished. Here you can see hardly, if it ever. Now the timepiece features a dial that is part and parcel to the Safari theme. Dark coloration on the calibrations as well as the hands at center, and the white gold applied numerals. The Luminova is black, and you can see that the numerals themselves are applied white gold, as the hands are at center, also white gold. There's a tachymeter scale outboard, sporting in intent. It doesn't perfectly fit the Safari theme, rather it is motorsports themed, understanding that you're more likely to find yourself in proximity perhaps to a racetrack than a rhino. This is a nod to that reality from Audemars Piguet. Now you'll note that the mega tapisserie features a lacquered coloration to achieve that savanna off-white. There is a beautiful glossy lacquer on top of the hobnail mega tapisserie cut, and then the sub-registers have a lighter silver coloration and they are countersunk into the dial. As ever, the date is buried deep down there in the bass movement because the Dubois de Praz vertical clutch chronograph module 3840 sits on top of the Audemars Piguet manufacturer base caliber 3126. Now the 3126 has a 55 hour power reserve. It's bidirectional automatic winding because AP deliberately wanted to reject the unidirectional winding rotor wobble characteristic of competing oversized sports watches powered by Valjoux 7750 base movements, so they went with bidirectional winding, but they added ceramic rotor bearings to ensure that this bidirectional system is smooth like a bidirectional rotor, but also efficient with the ceramic bearings. Now, the base caliber also features a full balance bridge and a free sprung index, meaning it is very tough. So it's resilient in the face of shocks, vibrations, and bumps and concussion on the wrist. Thanks to the screw down crown and robust case seals, the watch is also 100 meters water resistant. So should you take it for a swim, simply put it on a water resistant diver strap. I find fitting a rubber strap, and one is readily available from Audemars Piguet, actually makes the watch fit better on a small wrist. So if you're around 15 centimeters wrist circumference, you're going to want to get the rubber diver strap to make this a better fit for your wrist. And with the diver strap, this will fit a 15 centimeter circumference wrist. Otherwise, the caliber is contemporary, beautifully made, beautifully decorated, and though you cannot see it, it bears the hallmarks of the finest grade of valet de jeu finish, courtesy of Audemars Piguet. You can see and you can purchase this Royal Oak Offshore Safari on our website.